today's episode, I take a look at setups on EURGBP, AussieCAD, and AussieJPY. Karabu has a supply and demand take on New Zealand dollar CAD, USD Swiss franc, Aussie dollar, New Zealand dollar, EuroCAD, and EURGBP. And Mntungwa has an Elliott Wave setup for us on GBP USD. We also have some action from our Discord trading room. Enjoy. All right, the first chart I want to discuss is that of EuroPound. Now, this is one that's been on the short list of many traders for many weeks. And we also started looking for some shorts once we reached this point of liquidity last week, but the market hasn't really responded as we would have hoped, and the market actually went a bit higher. Now, there's two scenarios that I'm looking for next week, and I'll be discussing both. One of them is that we might still be doing this correction at least until this first resistance point. As you guys can see, this has been one big move to the upside, and there's been this big liquidity voids to the downside. And the second scenario is actually for this market to even continue higher up to this liquidity point here before we might start looking for a bit of a reversal. But let's jump to the 4-hour time frame, and I'll show you guys what I'm going to look for next week. So just dropping to the 4-hour, one of the scenarios that we discussed last week and that we had up in our trading room was for this market to finish with a bit of an ending diagonal. And that would give us a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 count before the market comes down. Now, the market went a little bit higher than we expected, but this is actually quite normal. This could what we call the overthrow, and it's actually quite a good thing to see. And this setup can still play out, and maybe next week we'll have a bit of a correction, and then maybe at this pivot point here we can find a bit of a short position, and then hopefully we can ride this down to this lower level. However, much is going to depend on the price action next week, because there's a second scenario that I would like to throw out there, and that is that this market is actually just finished with a bit of a running flat correction. Now, if this is the case, what this means is that we had our big impulsive move here, and that this was our first correction, and after this correction finishes, we'll go even higher to those levels that we marked on the previous time frame. Now, what this means next week, I'll have to look at the price actions to see, if I want to be looking for the short or maybe even long. Now, if the market comes down a little bit lower, and I would have actually liked this market to clear these lows to break a bit of structure before looking for the shorts. But if this market next week makes a bit of a rounded bottom and just continues higher, then I'm just gonna stay out of the short position. But if the market does maybe break this low and then we see a corrective move, maybe an ABC or a different kind of pattern, and it seems like a corrective move, then this is when I'll be looking to get short in the market. So just note that there is a chance that this market could continue higher. So don't just think because the market has been running for all these weeks straight that it's going to have to come down. Be prepared for both scenarios and look at the price action to give you an indication of which way this market wants to go. All right, next up I want to look at a couple of Aussie dollar pairs. And I've been looking for some Aussie dollar strength the whole year, since pretty much the beginning of the year, and that hasn't really materialized yet. But looking at the Aussie dollar pairs across the board, there seems that there might be a bit of a bounce coming. So I'm going to look at two of them. The first one is the Aussie dollar CAD weekly. And as you guys can see here, we had this big impulsive move, and then we had this slow grind down to take these lows, much like the Euro New Zealand dollar chart that we've been discussing all year. And I'm expecting much of the same move for this market to go up and finish a bit of a bigger time frame correction, either a running flat or a expanding flat. But the minimum, if we do get a bit of a reversal, I do expect this market to come all the way up to these highs. And the main thing to note here is that the market did spike these lows, and then we had the big reaction. So it did pick up all this liquidity at the bottom. And if it wants to move higher, then now might be a good time. Now, I've dropped down to the 8-hour time frame, and this actually looks quite promising. This is the liquidity that we ran. And as you guys can see, the market came down, made this little bit of a left shoulder, came down, and then we have this big impulsive move. Now, this is already setting up for one of our reversal patterns. So hopefully next week we can either make a bit of a running flat, although I'm hoping that this is not going to be the case. What I'm going to be hopefully looking for next week is for this market to grind down and at least take these lows, maybe even all the way down to this pivot level. As you guys can see, there's a big, nice bullish order block here. So hopefully if we can get down to this level, here we can find a nice little tight short, and then hopefully we can ride this market all the way to the upside. And the last one is the Aussie dollar JPY. These are the two Aussie dollar pairs that kind of look the best to me if you are looking for Aussie dollar longs. And this one is actually setting up nicely, quite nicely structurally. As you guys can see here, we came down, we had the correction, came down, had the correction, came down. then had this big accumulation and then the strong move out. And hopefully this is a bit of a correction, and once this correction finishes, we'll end up going higher. So I've got an alert on these lows here, and I'm looking for this market, much like the previous pair, to come down to touch these lows. Now, there's two ways to trade this. You can either have a bit of a set and forget pending here if you want to take the long here, or you can look for some lower time frame reversal patterns at this level. And hopefully we will, as much as the other Aussie dollar pairs, will end up going higher. I got my first resistance coming in at this level, 77.55. So this is where I'll be taking first profits if this works out, and maybe moving my stop loss a bit. And hopefully we can get even higher after this. Anyway, those are the setups for me. Next up is Karaba and Mtungwa with their setups for the week. Enjoy.
Good day, traders. I've got lots of currency pair to share with you today. So without wasting any time, let us dive in on the chart. My first one, it is the NZD CAD. As I have previously mentioned, we had this demand zone, which was that demand zone, and it was removed by the supply zone, which is currently in control. So what I'm expecting, it is a better push to the downside, at least to this demand zone. And my second pair, it is the USDCHF. We clearly have this impulse going to the upside, and price is coming down in a corrective move. So what I'm looking for, it is a further push down into this demand zone for a potential long opportunity. What I like about this demand zone, it is this gap, price gap through the level, which indicates a greater demand over here. So something to look out for. And my third pair, it is the AUD NZD. I previously marked off this demand zone, and it has been hit twice already. If price breaks, the next level to look for going long, it is at this demand zone over here, or going to that supply zone. And my fourth pair, it is EuroCAD. I still believe that price will drop all the way to this demand zone. So a better way to time an entry from the weekly is at the daily time frame. We currently have this supply zone. So if price rallies, we could get an entry and going short. This could be your initial profit target for a more conservative target, or you could just hold on your trade from the weekly perspective till this at this demand zone over here. And my fifth pair, it is the EURJBP. I'm still short from this supply zone, still looking for price to push further down. So for my profit target, I am looking to clear my profits at this level, because we could still get a bounce from this level, price then take off. So that's something to look out for. Or alternatively, we can still press down into this demand zone and prepare for a lift off. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Cheers.
Hello, traders. I hope everyone is having a very good weekend and looking forward for the market next week. Going forward, I just want to share the pound US dollar. What I'm looking at here, we are looking at this wave that needs to complete at the blue box, completing this three waves that will we want it to terminate at the blue box. So apparently what I'm looking at this to come and break the low before we look at something different from this area around this low over here. So price has been falling ever since with the 1-2-3 structure, and it automatically gave us the very big corrective structure that is a expanded flat. So what we're looking at to get the move to the downside that will eventually come to the blue box. So I'm looking at this move to eventually start building like this. Using a different color, we had this from year 1, 2, 3. Then we had this corrective structure in the middle of a year. Therefore, I'm expecting this to give me 1, 2, 3 again to the downside. Either way, it terminates to the low or it terminates to the blue box. It will depend whether we're going to break these levels, this low, and come to the blue box, or we will just terminate at the low and go to the upside. Let me just push a little bit to the smaller time frame and see what we are having around this area. We went down from this area. We see this pattern here was completed. Therefore, we went down to this area. Now we are getting a running flat over here. So all you should look for a corrective structure, then continue to take this to the nearest blue box or even up to the low. If price continue to move up to this level over here, to this bigger 61, so all you can do is to move to break even and take this to the low. So either way, you get a corrective structure next week, it breaks, you trade it. When you get to these levels over here, the 61, this 61 over here, so you will move your stop to break even and let the price run all the way to this low. That's what I'm looking at. Pound US dollar chess, guys. Enjoy. Have a good trading week ahead.
Set the soul.